Learn how to choose between Azure Table Storage and Azure Cosmos DB Table API in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Azure Table Storage and Azure Cosmos DB Table API are very similar and enable you to store data in rows and columns. So how do you know which one to use when? Let's take a look. I've created this simple console application. It has a reference to azure.data.tables. This is the SDK that you can use to talk to both Azure Table Storage and Azure Cosmos DB with the Table API. So you can point any table-based application to either service. Pretty cool. I already have an existing Azure Table Storage and Azure Cosmos DB, and these are their connection strings. All very standard. Okay. So what does the application do? Well, it takes the connection string for Azure Cosmos DB, creates a table service client, and then executes the run method. And then it does the same with a connection to Azure Table Storage. Let's look at the run method. This first deletes a table and creates it to make sure that it starts clean. And then it creates a new entity, which it writes to the table. It measures the time that it takes to do that, and it does that 500 times. Okay, and next it reads the entities from the table and also times that. All of this will show us which service is faster at reading and writing. Let's run it to see what happens. Here we go. First, it deletes and creates a table. Okay, and now it writes entities to the table. Cool. And then it reads the entities from the table. All right. That's it. And now it does the same for Azure Table Storage. Again, it does 500 iterations for reads and for the writes. Let's see if there is a difference between the two. Okay, that's it. So Azure Table Storage looks a little bit slower than Azure Cosmos DB. That makes sense. Okay then. So what else is different between these two services? Let's take a look at a summary of the biggest differences. First of all, they both offer flexible semi-structured storage of rows and columns. That core capability is the same for both services. And as we've just seen, you don't even have to change your application to switch between services. Now, where you need to have global performance and availability, you use Azure Cosmos DB. It can create writable nodes all over the world. Azure Table Storage can't do that. And if you need very high performance, you also choose Azure Cosmos DB, as we've just seen. It is faster, and it has latency included in its SLA, where it promises to have a low latency for read and write operations. Azure Table Storage doesn't have this in its SLA. So you can use Azure Cosmos DB Table API and Azure Table Storage with the same API and SDK. When you need extremely high global performance, you can use Azure Cosmos DB for your applications. And if you need fast and reliable semi-structured table storage, you can use Azure Table Storage. Go and check it out.